Hey, what's going on everybody? Ryan here. Today we're going to be talking about why it's important to buy into the market when it dips. Also, why is it important to continually lower your cost basis, which is the average purchase price that you buy into shares for in a particular company. In this video, I'm also going to be showing you an example of how I've applied this and how it's paid off in the long run. But first, if you're new to the channel and are interested in wealth building strategies such as stock market investing, and you want to watch me build my portfolio from a $4,000 portfolio all the way up to a very large portfolio, by February of next year, which is not too long, I'm going to have it up to a five-figure account, $10,000, and by 2021 February time, it's going to be up to above $25,000. Now, if you're interested in that, I'm going to be very transparent. I'm going to show you my mistakes, what I'm doing, how I'm doing it. Please consider subscribing to my channel by hitting the subscribe button down below. Also, smash that like button if you find value in my video. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment down below. So why is it important to buy into the market when it dips? Well, first of all, you want to find a company to invest in. You want to do your research, find that company and say, this one looks good. It's undervalued. I think it's going to be worth more. So you need to first buy in, whether or not that particular company is going down or up. All right. You just want to get in because you know that it's worth more than what it's at right now. Now, when it dips, you want to say, okay, it's down further. I want to buy more. All right. This also lowers your cost basis. Now, why do you want to do that? Well, it's kind of like going to the store and saying, I like that product, but it's on sale. It's 25% off. So I want to, are you going to say,
oh, no. I'll trust it when it goes back up in price.
No, you're going to just buy it. All right. You're going to be like,
ooh, I want this right now.
All right. So when you buy it, you're like, great. I just got it on sale. This is great. It's the same thing with a particular company that you invest in. If you know it's worth more and it goes down 25%, you're like, hallelujah. I just got a great deal on my hands right now. So you just go ahead and buy more shares. Now, why is this important? Let me show you a real example that currently paid off in the end of a company that I kept investing in. Now, I'm not sold out of this company at all, so it has a chance to lower its value again in the future, but the short-term effects are very relevant and very particular to this particular video, and let's go ahead and look at it. So on the screen, you can see I have Tesla. And as you may know from my previous video, if you don't, I'll leave a link above and in the description below of my portfolio. Now, I have a lot of my companies blocked out. And it's not that I don't want you to see them. It's in my other video if you want to know what they are. But this one is mostly focused on this particular topic, and that's Tesla. So Tesla, as you all know, or if you don't know, you will find out, it was struggling there throughout the entire year, this year of 2019. It had dropped as low as $180 a share, or around $180 a share, which is really low, especially since the year prior, it was around $370-$380 a share. Now, as you can see, I own 8 shares with a cost basis of $254.02. And if you see to the far right, it's actually up around 29.18%. which is phenomenal. It's $592.89 up for me, and that's how much I'm up. If I were to sell out, that's how much money I made off of this company. Now, notice that this is the average cost of all 8 of those shares. So what was my first share's purchase price? Well, when I first bought in, I bought in November of 2018 for $347.45. Now, if you look to the far right, I'm still down in this particular share, 5.6-ish% in this particular share. And that's not that great of a thing. But to make it even worse, let's look at the next purchase. It went up to about a 300 and high 70s and then dropped back down to 362. So I was like, it's down again. Let's go ahead and buy another share. I have the money available. Let's do it. And as you can see to the far right, I'm down about 10% almost in this particular share with an average of about $54, $53. Now, you might be saying, well, why'd you buy in? I mean, that's kind of dumb. Why aren't you supposed to buy in when it goes down? Well, it did go down. It was up at around 300 and high 70s. And now it's down to 362. So I was like, might as well. I have the money. and I wanted to make my position bigger in this company. Now, as you all know, in 2019, it started to drop and drop and drop, and eventually got into the high $180, $190 range. And when it started to go up, I decided to double my position because I had the funds available to do so. And I bought two shares for $201.68 a share. As you can see to the far right, because it's been doing so good recently due to the last quarter's earnings, I'm up 62.7%, up $252.91, which outweighs the first two's negatives. This already shows you why it's important to lower your cost basis when the market dips, especially for those companies that you have confidence in, that you're bullish about, that you know are worth more than what they are currently valued at. But as you can see, that's only four shares. What did I buy the other four shares for? So on the screen, you could see that my last purchase, I doubled my position again. I bought all four shares for $229.60 because I had the funds available, and it was around 140, 150 recently, and then dropped down just before earnings to 229.60. So I was like, I'm going to do it. Might as well. I want to lower my cost basis even more because it was sitting, my cost basis before I made this purchase was around 278. And I was like, I want to make it lower. So now it's at 254 because of these shares. You could see to the far right, I'm up 42.91%, $394. So that plus the other one is well over the two shares that I am down in. Now, this is why it's important to lower your cost basis and buy in when the market dips in the companies that you have confidence in, all right? If you don't have confidence in the company, this won't work because you will constantly be having stress, anxiety, because you're like, I don't know if it'll ever go up. If you don't know it will go up, you shouldn't be buying into these companies. Now, if you have strong confidence in these companies, just keep buying in. Lower your cost basis, because when it starts to go up, you will see the increase in your wealth. Now, keep this in mind. If I were to have just waited until the price of Tesla went back up to the original price that I purchased it for, I'd still be waiting today. But the point is that I lowered my cost basis, and now I'm up above 29% in Tesla. So keep that in mind. That's the message I got for you today. Buy in when the market dips, lower your cost basis, and smash that like button if you found value in this video. And if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button over to my right. It's got an ugly mug on it, just like this one right here. And I will see you in the next video.